Hello, everyone. Welcome to CyberScoop TV. I'm your managing editor, Greg Otto. We're coming to you from the 2017 RSA conference, and I'm talking with Tim Jarrett, the director of enterprise security for Veracode. Tim, thanks for joining us today.
My pleasure.
So talk to me about what you're seeing as far as the advancements in helping large enterprises secure all the applications that are sitting on their network.
There's a couple of things that we found that are really important, but a lot of it comes down to empowering developers to understand what application security is about and what they can do to address it. And that takes a couple of different forms. You can do formal training, you can do coaching to help them understand, you know, in the context of the application that they're building. And, you know, fundamentally, it's also about giving them the psychological safety in some ways to know that nobody's going to beat up on them for making a coding mistake that leads to a security vulnerability.
Right. Let's talk about, you know, the developers that are on that coding level. You know, a lot of developers have been trained to think, you know, the code is the code. They just assume that it is secure. So how are you seeing your customers react or sort of evolve to understand that, okay, some of this might just be inherently insecure, but we'll have this product to help you out before it turns into a really big problem?
Yeah, I think the historic problem has been twofold. Number one, I don't think that we've given developers enough credit as a security industry. The ones that we talk to are understanding very much that security is an issue, and part of that's just the rising tide of breaches that we've had over
right.
the last few years. But they don't necessarily know what to do about it. And for a long time also, security has kind of held on to the application security and safety function. And what we're seeing works better is if you give developers the coaching and understanding, they'll run with it. They think about it as a quality problem, and then, you know, they think about it in terms of their ownership of the code. What can they do to continue to improve that quality early in the process so they can get ahead of the problem and not get stuck at the end of a release cleaning up security bugs and missing their ship date?
So you kind of touched on this a little bit, but let's talk about how automation is just helping so much and helping these larger enterprises really catch up to their security needs.
Yeah, no, that's an extremely important point because without automation, you can't scale to the level of applications that you have in a typical large enterprise. And that's twofold. Number one, there are just so many applications to cover. You can't hire enough security professionals to cover them all. You need automation to support that. The other thing that's changing is that code is being developed and released more rapidly with the advent of things like continuous integration and DevOps.
Right.
So you need the automation to just keep up with the pace of change.
How do you see, how do you see secure DevOps working in agencies? Is it something that is catching on in agencies? Because I seem to be hearing more and more about it.
So we see it in just about every sector that we look at,
okay.
But we see it on the project level.
Okay.
We are now just starting to get to the point where beyond a few leading edge internet companies that it's being done like universally inside one organization. It's much more common for a small team to pick up and start doing practices that continuous integration and some of the related disciplines of DevOps. And then, you know, we are starting to see at the enterprise level, architects and other folks step up and say, this is great, let's start adopting some of these more globally. And they'll do things like build a standard way that software gets developed and say, all software goes through that. So adoption and interest are high, but what's, you know, kind of where we are now is that people are trying to figure out how to go from one and two projects to scaling again those things and those practices across the whole enterprise.
Great. Tim, appreciate your insight. Thanks for letting us talk with you a little bit about what you're seeing.
Greg, my pleasure.
All right. For all of our videos, check out our YouTube channel, and for all things cybersecurity, check out cyberscoop.com. I'm Greg Otto. Thanks for watching.